Analytics with Nags. This is another video in the Catch Up with Nags series where I'm going to discuss about Power BI September 2021 updates. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin our today's topic. So in September 2021, there are two updates as of now. And first, I want to discuss about this Fortune 500 pharmaceutical company leverages Power BI and ValQ software. What is that? See, basically, like lot of companies, why Power BI is so famous, because a lot of Fortune 500 companies are using, especially in pharmaceutical sector, they have used it. So in this, I hope it's kind of a case study, or they can say like Power BI is used in most of the Fortune companies. They announced it, and they have some combination like Microsoft Azure, Power BI and ValQ, right? So what are those things and how it is closely related to Power BI? So that is what it is explained. If you watch this half an hour video, I hope it is half an hour, I watched it. I cannot summarize all the points that has been covered, but I can quickly give you a glimpse of about it. So basically, a finance director from a Fortune 500 pharmaceutical company presented his how this Power BI is used for their business. And they explained a lot of concepts here. Let's quickly go through this architecture. As you can see, like, they face the same problems that we have explained in the Power BI. I mean, BI world, they need to integrate from different sources. So where they need to store, it's a new age development platform, BI platform. So they opted for a Azure data lake storage. Then for processing, they use Azure Databricks and kind of some kind of machine learning. Then they use the reportings, right, for presentation, and for process automation, they use Power Apps. Then the end user comes here. So this is the architecture they followed. So what I'm trying to tell here is, like, when you are involved in Power BI, your work not only involved only in Power BI. You may have to also have a knowledge on storing a data engineering process, how data can be moved to data lakes, how can be processed, right? So mostly people prefer those who learn all the technologies. That is the point I want to make here. And this organization uses this architecture. And if you are involved only in Power BI, there will be chances, that is different topic, how you can get into Power BI alone, right? I have talked more about in career guidance, you can check it out. So this company uses this architecture, and using this, they have solved most of the problem, like they can't able to integrate, right? One system from one system, it has to come input from other system, the process has to be flown. But they find very difficult. So this architecture helped them to solve the business problem. The next point is, like, they talked about ValQ software, which is like this ValQ software integrated with the Power BI as well. This is for automation or simulation. The simulation capability is enabled in this ValQ software. That is what the key aspect they explain. The simulation capability begins with demand signal, which while volume assumptions flow download to trigger each process. Basically, like once the process is started, based on the demand, the planning process should start, then the finance things should start. So those things, how ValQ software has helped, right? And how they embedded that in the Power BI. Those things they explain in this full article. You can go through it. It is really worth you learn these things in real practical world, how a tool that you are learning is used in the organizations. That will be really helpful. Let's move on to our next topic, export Power BI report in a file API. Now we have export in a file or PPT or some concepts, right, in the Power BI services. Now there will be a new API is going to be released, that is under preview. That is what it is explained here. Export Power BI report to a file API allows you to export to PDF, PPT, PNG, that is image, by using a REST API calls. This is another feature, and it has some restrictions based on the capacity. The number of Power BI exports per hour will not limited to 50 per hour per capacity. So there are some limitations as well. So these are the two things that is announced in Power BI, and let me catch up in another video next week.